Welcome back, everybody. Today we're going over that target that you see downrange from shootsteel.com. What we're going to do, take a closer look at the system, see how they set it up, talk about the pros of it. Number one is going to be portability for me. It absolutely sets up in like less than 30 seconds, which I love, but we'll take a closer look at it and let you know what I think of it overall, some of the details of it. And other than that, we'll just keep shooting it. So that's what's up today, guys. Target system is really composed of three different pieces. You have your target, which you see here, the hardware to mount it, and then the base. But we'll go over the target first. This one here is the 12 by 20 inch ISPC scale target, scaled down target. So not quite as big, but still has the same outline for those of you guys that shoot competitions. It'll be good practice for you there. This one here is quarter inch steel, and like all AR500 targets, the edges are CNC cut. So the advantage of that is a couple things. Sometimes when companies are cutting out their steel targets, they'll use a plasma cutter, and the heat from the plasma cutter messes with the heat treatment on the AR500 steel, and what that does is it weakens it. So a lot of companies around the edges, it'll be weaker, and you'll see a lot of nicks happening in your targets when you shoot the edges. As you can see here, I've had this one in for a couple months now, shot it a lot really in every one of my videos in the last few months that involve handguns anyway. And no damage to the target at all. I actually left the target unpainted so you guys could see where it's hit. There's no issues. And this target here was shot with 9mm and 10mm ammunition. So no issues there at all. The target is rated up to 45, so I don't know if 10mm is gonna be in there, but I have shot it with that and have had no ill effects. I believe Shoot Steel says you can shoot these 10 yards and back safely. So obviously I recommend that you do follow those guidelines. But I was shooting it mostly at 12 yards for what it's worth. Now, the second part of the system is going to be your hardware, which you see part of it right here. You can see this has actually been shot several times and actually still has no ill effects. So certainly looks like the hardware is doing pretty well. But it consists of a half inch carriage bolt, which you see here, the spring, which is supposed to be not all that tight. It's supposed to be sort of compressed a little bit so that it will actually spring back and forth and make that very loud audible sound when it's being hit, but not compressed all the way down, because if you did that, then it wouldn't actually ring and it wouldn't move back and forth, which provides for some added safety as well. So this is the hardware that you get for mounting it. Basically how it works is that you have your half inch, or your, excuse me, not half inch, your 2x4 that fits in between the little steel bracket there, and then this rides on top of it. The bolt rides on top, so that way it keeps it from sliding down the post. A very simple design, and works as designed, I suppose. The base of the target stand is also made of a heavy gauge steel, as you can see there. Very durable, so that way if you do have errant shots that hit it, it will stand up to it. You can see spalling is really nothing to this target base, because there's a lot that has been shot on here, and there's been no ill effects outside of ruining the paint on it, but obviously that's something you can cover up very quickly. I believe it's 20 inches long, 16 inches wide, and it does have these little holes here on all four quarters, so that way you can stake it down if you are on uneven ground, soft ground, or if you're just shooting it with, like, say, heavy rifles, because this stand, I've been using it with the handgun targets, but you can use it with any of their targets to include their heavy rifle targets. So very simple to use. You can go ahead and drop your 2x4 in there, drop it down in, and then you just tighten it up with these little tensioning screws here, and that'll keep it solid and in place and not moving around and flopping around in the wind or under recoil. So very durable little product here, and like I said, it works with any of their stands, which I really like. Any of their heads, I should say, which I really like. And this one here comes to market, I believe it's $64 is the list price. The original target there that we just showed was $64. The hardware, I believe, $16. And the little plate, which is 3/8 inch steel that mounts onto your 2x4 that you guys have seen throughout the video, is, I believe, $18. Don't quote me on those prices, but they're pretty close at least. That plate there that you're looking at here, what it exists for is to stop exactly what you see here, because I don't have it on this piece of 2x4, but these bullet holes that were a little bit lower the target will eventually obviously add up and you'll have to replace it. So that one there will prevent that and get you a greater service life in your 2x4, which is certainly a nice thing. Long-time viewers of the channel here have seen me review targets from all different sizes, shapes, different materials, several steel ones as well in the past. And without question, the ShootSteel.com targets are as good as any of them. Like I said, great way of CNC cutting them, preserving the strength of the edges. All the AR500 steel is heat-treated. They have a ton of different options in terms of thickness and what they're rated for, as well as different size options and different mounting options as well. They have popper targets as well as the static targets that you saw here. Really a lot of different options if you check their website out. Right now I don't have a coupon code, but I'm going to hit them up as soon as this video is published. And if I can get a viewer coupon code, check right here for it. If not, search around the internet for it. But really, all in all, a lot of good options here from Shoot Steel. Like all static targets, this one has an added benefit too that I didn't talk about, where you can flip it around, because all targets will eventually wear down and start to develop craters. And on this one, when that happens, you can just flip it around and you have essentially a brand new target to start working on and start wearing down on the backside. So it's going to last a long, long time. Certainly something that we all like here. But if you guys have any questions about this target, anything else I review here on the channel, you can always post below in the comment section. You can also post over at my Facebook page as always. But thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for subscribing. And I'll see you in the next video.